Let's talk about some genius marketing strategies for small business with Billie Jean is marketing. Trust me, you're gonna wanna see this expert interview coming at you. We're getting started right now. What is up, Zachary Babcock here, former drug addict, spent over 5 years of my life in prison, turned underdog entrepreneur, and the proven wrong prodigy with a top 200 rated podcast on iTunes. What is up, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, make sure you hit the subscribe button and tap the bell notifications if you want the best tips on lead generation and customer acquisition. With that out the way, let's dive right into this. We're gonna dive into some key baller marketing strategies with Billie Jean is marketing. So without any further ado, let's dive right into the interview.
What's the keys though, you know, like with, obviously, you know, you gotta find your strong suit of what you're really good at, but how important is that instead of trying to be like a jack of all trades?
It all comes down to messaging. And so for example, when you meet someone in person, a lot of you may struggle with kind of figuring out how to make business out of those kind of meetings. And the reason is because you're probably unable to communicate your message. So for example, the person says like, oh yeah, like I'm an entrepreneur and like I'm a marketing guy. Okay, people hear you, they understand. But when you say, hey, I'm the guy that people call when they want to create an ad, but they have no idea how to do video. So they call me and I do the scripts and Now all of a sudden you've just visualized how you solve problems and it makes it easy for people to connect with you. But the same challenge comes when you try and promote your business. When you try and promote your business and it's not clear exactly what someone's going to get as a result of working with you, it's like fucking impossible to sell. Really, 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 really challenging. So I would say that's probably the biggest area that I see people mess up. Yeah, that's where a lot of people in the life coaching industry, that's why they struggle online, because they can't put a finger on that thing that they solve. And as a result, their message is everywhere. And
100%, dude. It's funny you mentioned that, because I struggled with that of all of 2017 until I got really specific, like, okay, I'm an underdog. I fucking went through prison, all this shit. I'm going to help underdog entrepreneurs, people looking to get into entrepreneurship, just starting out, or underdog business owners in general. Once that happened, like you said, once that happened, dude, things started taking off. Like, it's insane.
It's so micro, but it's like everything, you know?
Yeah, man. Totally, dude. 100%. That kind of leads me into another question from another member from the Underdog Empowerment Group. He asked, so Tony wanted to know, how important of a role is copywriting in when you're video heavy, you know, when your content's video heavy?
Funny. At the core of every video is good writing. So 100. Like when you see the video, like the writing is the beginning, right? Before you have a video, you got to have something to write. You have to have a story to tell. So it's everything. It's fucking everything. Like all you got to think about it. All the internet is when you're selling something is using words to make someone take out their credit card. Yeah. If you're not good with words, then you can't do anything in regards to business online, period. The end of conversation. So that's what I meant by practice in the beginning. A lot of you should be taking the next 6 months and stop worrying about selling and take copywriting courses from the people that are the best in the industry and just practice writing every single day. You may feel like you're taking a step back, but then when you come back into the marketplace, you will grow 100 times faster than the person who never hunkered down to actually learn something and become a master at something.
Yeah, man, that's powerful right there, dude. Real powerful, man. And before we continue to dive deep on like these tactics of growing your agency and just winning with Facebook advertising, I kind of want to shift gears here for a second and talk about how did you, you know, tell us a little bit more about your story. Like, how did you get so passionate about advertising and marketing in general, and your story on where you got to where you're at today?
There's a lot to my story, so I'll unpack that a bit. So marketing, it wasn't like I had this like dream to be a marketer. I learned about marketing when I had my oil change company and I realized that I had no way to get customers. And from doing that, I learned that there's this, like I finally understood marketing's place, because when marketing is taught in school, they go with like the four P's, like price, product, promotion, and they never, it's the most abstract, like broad advice ever. But what is over, and I went to University of San Diego's business school, what's overshadowed there is just the simple fact of how to get a customer. Like, there should be a class in college called how to get my first fucking customer. Yeah. And it's never taught anywhere. It's assumed. So when I was actually out in the streets and I was doing my oil change company, I had this like business plan because that's what I thought I needed. And I had like my logo and I had my website and I did all that. And I had no fucking clue on how to actually get a customer. And so I did door hangers. I did knocking on doors. I did Groupon before it was hot. Like right when Groupon was coming up, I did it and I saw how well that worked. But even the concept of Groupon like really messed with my head because I didn't get how it made sense to give Groupon half my revenue on my already discounted price of 50%. And they're like, well, you have to pay to acquire the customer, then you just need to sell them more stuff. And that concept was so foreign to me that I thought they were on crack. I was like, are you guys kidding me? We lose money. And then finally, as I tried other things, I was like, oh my gosh, that Groupon person's right. I got to pay to give away something for cheap. And I learned that you have to even pay to give away something for free. So that was the hardest lesson of marketing that I learned is the fact that like this shit cost. And the way that we ended up monetizing Groupon is we would go to individuals, and once we showed up to their house, we would say, well, what company do you work at? And then we said, can you set us up with a meeting with the manager or whoever to see if we can come every single day in the same week and change everybody's oil? And that was really the game. So we realized the Groupon was just a way for us to get to a customer to ultimately try and get to their to the company, which was the larger back end. And then I realized that was business, period, and how it works. If you look at the movie theater, they get you in because Deadpool 2 just came out, which I want to see, by the way. But then they get their money because they charge you $25 for one popcorn, not like a whole bag, like a popcorn kernel. Yeah. That's it. You know what I'm saying? So like, you know, that was the game.
Yeah, man, dude, that's fire right there, dude. So like, kind of I want to dig a little bit deep on that because, you know, I could obviously tell you're really passionate about, you know, the education system. Like, what are your thoughts about that? And I know you got some plans in the work for all that going on.
Yeah, we're currently in the process of building out a studio with 30 to 40 seats where people can come and learn in person. But also, it's like the ultimate place to broadcast from live. It'll be like the sickest design with a lot of cool things to make it really entertaining. But right now, I'm like perplexed at when you look at the country, the U.S., and you see how much debt is acquired through education. And then a politician comes in the office, and because it sounds good to say I'm all for education, they start doing things that give banks more freedom to give away loans to people. And so now it seems like school is more affordable and people can go there. But the fucked up part is people are coming in, acquiring all this debt for this free money that they're giving away. And then they end up paying it off over the next 30 years. The problem of the process of borrowing money is fine if you're learning something that actually is going to help you monetize and actually get a return. When they're giving away a business administration degree, the information is so general and so outdated that they're virtually selling people bullshit and wasting their time and not giving them an actual advantage to get a big ROI. And that's why I think it's the biggest legal scam in the world, because it doesn't fucking make any sense at all. Like the fact that they're not teaching about Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube, and that's the number one. If you ask any small business owner how they're going to grow their business, all of them are going to say social media. How many colleges in the world, including like your Harvards, are teaching anything fucking relevant to actually get that done?
Right.
None. And the way the system is created, semester by semester, trimester by trimester, it's virtually like, or quarterly, like they can't even keep up with the speed. Like what happens when Facebook comes out with Messenger bots and they go, okay, cool, we do need to teach that. So let's go ahead and do a class on it next semester. That's a 6-month wait.
Yeah.
It moves too fast for them. That's why I created the Gene Pool, where every single week I'm teaching and every single month I teach a new skill. Because it's virtually impossible to expect success by going that old route. It's stupid.
All right, did you guys find that interview very insightful? Did what Billy had to say help you in your business? Was there any aha moments or anything that really stuck out to you that gave you clarity moving forward in your business? If so, give this video a thumbs up right now and leave me a comment down below if this video was helpful. If it wasn't, if it sucked, if you didn't learn anything new, or if you just felt like there could be way more useful content here, give it a thumbs down right now and let me know in the comments below why it sucked or why you thought it could be better. Because I really do appreciate your honest and sincere feedback, because I want to make better YouTube videos. I want to be able to engage you and give you videos that are going to help you here on this channel. So your feedback really is appreciated. If you haven't already subscribed to this channel, hit the subscribe button and tap the bell notifications right now if you want the best tips on lead generation and customer acquisition. Thank you for tuning in. I will see you on the next video. And until then, you can check out one of these videos I'm going to share with you right now.
We put them hours in to bring them dollars in. It's that underdog empowerment. We put them hours in to bring them dollars in.
My name is Zachary Babcock.
Yeah, it's that underdog.